the enemy lately is using mines very extensively. So against those mines, you have to have some kind of protection. And the protected mobility is one of the challenges that we have. And of course, the ANA, or as any other army, would like to have tanks, EPCs, and various equipment to enhance the capability of the army. In other words, we will need enablers, whether it's artillery in the logistic area, in the Air Force, firepower, whatever. We are working to that end, and the international community is helping, particularly the US, so we appreciate that. And hopefully by the time ISAF NATO leaves this country, ANA will be fully capable of doing its mission to protect the country, to protect the people, and help the police in their missions.
Of course, new vehicles will bring with them a training burden. Now, I know that on this trip you've been spending time with the UK forces as they train to deploy to Afghanistan. Are you envious of that sheer level of training?
Well, you see, envious, you could be envious for anything, you know, even at home with somebody. But the question is, I mean, they have not just learned and acquired all the things overnight. They've worked for many, many years. So I'm, happy to have such friends like the British or the Americans or the other NATO nations helping my army. And I'm sure one day we'll have a well-trained army, if not 100% to that standard, close to it. You see, one of the problems in the last 30 years of civil war, we have lost the opportunity for young people to go to school, and the literacy is another threat within the country, within the army. So the more you have educated people, the better they will have training, the better they will understand and use the equipment. So we will be working for that end. It will take us longer, but we are resilient and we are committed to train our army to the required standard.
Just finally, to come back to equipment, you just have to look out over the airfield at Kandahar or Bagram and see the tens of billions of dollars worth of unmanned systems, other intelligence assets on the ground there, as well as, of course, as fast jets. With the best will in the world, you're never going to have anything like that capability. Will you still be able to win without that support?
You see, we are winning because our cause is legitimate. We are protecting our own people. We are protecting our country. We are defending our country. So this is the main power behind the mentality and the motivation of the people. And that's why my soldiers, my people are very motivated. And secondly, the equipment that we have now, the training that we have, are for the internal security of the present enemy situation is sufficient to hit the enemy, to defeat the enemy. But what happens in future, in the long term, an army with a lot of equipment will be based on an economy, the resources that you can afford. And of course, a country without army cannot survive.